was born in Massachusetts, lived in Cincinnati, moved to Texas in 1940. Both my brother and sister served in World War II. And of course, my father in World War I. And my brother was on a submarine in the South Pacific. And my sister was an Army nurse. And listen, during the war, everybody in this country had to do something.
David McNerney entered military service upon graduation from high school in 1949. After completing a tour in Korea with the U.S. Navy, McNerney joined the Army in 1954. By 1967, McNerney was serving his third tour in Vietnam as a first sergeant with the 8th Infantry. But all his years of military experience could not have prepared him for the ambush his company would face on the afternoon of March 22nd, while searching for a lost reconnaissance team in Polei Doc.
This had to be out of Pleiku up along the Cambodian border. We went in on a hellebore assault. It was a hot spot, I suppose. We had had a LERP team that got lost, or wasn't answering the radio, wasn't doing the, we went in to find them. And then we found something. We started to move out the next morning, and we immediately ran into an ambush. Firefight, contact. And my normal position was at the rear, company commander was up forward, and the contact was in front. So I had left the rear and went to the front, and there were two dead, of our dead. So I went past the dead and the wounded there and advanced about 50, maybe 50 yards, seeing what was going on. And all of a sudden, somebody opened up on me with non-med equipment. And I know they were going by my head, and I could feel them, but the son of a bitch missed me. I killed him, and then there was more fire coming, and I threw a grenade, and then they threw a grenade, and it landed right beside me. I went to the ground, and it blew up, and it just lifted me. But none of the shrapnel caught me. It was just debris. I continued firing every time I saw movement. And then there was movement to the front, and some of the guys were saying, "I see him, First Sergeant, I see him." And I said, "Well, fire." The machine gun fired one round, and jammed. And he got shot. And then everybody started firing. Well, we had been in firefights before, but this was really eyeball to eyeball kind of stuff.
When his company commander and artillery forward observer were killed, Sergeant McNerney took command. As the enemy closed in, McNerney called in artillery fire to within 20 meters of his position. Despite his injuries and in the face of constant enemy fire, McNerney moved to a nearby clearing to designate the location for friendly aircraft. When explosives were needed to clear landing space to evacuate the wounded, McNerney crawled outside his perimeter to gather demolition materials from abandoned rucksacks. His fearless actions prevented the company from being overrun by a North Vietnamese force that outnumbered them 3-1.
Well, I'll tell you, that day, I had a feeling that I wouldn't be killed. And it was just there. You're not gonna die. And it lasted me all day and all night. And I don't know why. It was just kind of like when I was winning at a poker hand. You know, you play poker, you know, you're lucky, you know your things are going to go your way. It was that kind of a feeling. The troops, to me, they were children, my children, I suppose, like I said, the paternal feeling. felt responsible for them, and of course we still get together a lot of times. I was very pleased with them, though. I think everybody in the country would have been pleased with them. As a personal triumph, yeah. Probably, naturally, it'd be the highest thing I've ever accomplished. It was kind of a culmination of everything that I'd been taught and did in my environment from World War II. The 90 people that helped me get it or earned it, it means a lot to them, and it means a lot to me. I think, you know, everybody in the company felt, look, we did this, and the first sergeant got the medal.